You need to man up, Nancy. Never looking in the
rear. It didn't go well.
No, it did go well.
Oh, well, hey!
Well, we hear this pretty damn often, don't we? You need to man up. Be a man. Hey, be a man. Do the right thing. So, man up, that's common. Why don't we hear anyone saying, woman up? Just, hey, girlfriend, you know, just, you need a woman up, man, okay? No, we don't, because there's no such thing. Manning up means that you need to rise up to the challenge of being a man. Fulfilling the role that you are expected to fill as a man. For example, marrying a woman and tacking her on, which in the past a dowry was given in the reference to the fact that this would be a burden for you, that you would have to provide for the woman, you would have to work a lot for the family and children. That would be manning up, okay? There's some expectation there, just like men don't get called sluts, right? Because it's actually a challenge, okay, to be a family man, be a husband is very difficult. More specifically, there is a lot of risk, especially when you draw it up and you compare it to the rewards that you're getting, especially in modern times. So that's why no one's saying woman up. No one's saying, hey man, you know, you need to get married and you just sit at home and put all the laundry in the like factory made washing machine and put the TV dinner in the microwave and watch Oprah at 1 o'clock. no one's telling you to rise to the difficult role that's expected of you of watching Days of Our Lives at midday while your husband goes to work in the coal mine. Now, when it comes to accusations against MGTOW, the common one would be, hey, be a man. And this is done many, many times, many different spheres of society, different things. When it comes to MGTOW, that's one of them. Some other ways that might come up is, oh, well, you know, obviously you can't handle a strong, independent woman. You know, if you're a strong man, you'd be able to handle a strong woman. And some other ones might be, oh, you're afraid of women. Obviously you're afraid of women. You're lacking self-confidence. You know, men, they're the risk takers. So why aren't you taking the risk and getting married? Obviously, you're just a little loser because you don't want to take a massive fucking risk. Or, no, maybe you're a smart man, okay? It doesn't matter if you're alpha, beta, omega. Maybe you're a smart man and you calculate it and you said, hey, I'm all about taking risks, but I only take risks once I've calculated it and cross-reference it with the reward, okay? No, it's not smart. There's nothing valiant or good about, say, making a stupid investment. And similarly with marriage. Why would you make a stupid investment in marriage? Okay? There's nothing manly about that. Okay? If anything, if we want to talk about masculinity, I think if there's something manly, it's about taking responsibility for yourself and being discerning and being intelligent and saying, is this really going to serve me, this decision that I'm making? So let's just get into some more details here. Let's look at the charge of fear. You're afraid of women. Well, I think that somebody could reject women or ignore them because they're afraid of them. That could be possible, like the true, forced, lonely guy. But just because you abstain from something doesn't mean you're afraid from it, okay? For example, if you look at Christian people, a lot of them attempt to abstain from sex. Doesn't mean they're afraid of it, okay? They do that for other reasons. Me personally, I abstain from certain things, like I don't drink alcohol, I don't eat meat, I don't drink coffee, and I'm not afraid of eating meat, trust me, I'm not afraid of eating meat. I've done a fair amount of drinking and some drugs in my life. I'm not afraid of being intoxicated either. I just don't think that those things serve me well, and that's why I don't engage in them. I've made a calculation, and the risk and the reward I've decided that those things aren't worth it. It's not that I'm afraid. And similarly with MGTOW, on the whole, I would say that's not the motivating factor. And this does tie in already with taking risks, okay? Because a real man, a strong man who's going to man up, is really going to rise up to the occasion. A true man is someone who takes risks, okay? He's confident, and basically the risk means sacrifice, okay? So here I'd like to reference some comment from Bill Burr. He says that, you know, let's say that you went skydiving and, you know, you had a 75% chance that your parachute wouldn't open. Just like 75% of chance with managers that it's going to go into the shit. There's 50% divorce rate and there's 50% of people who don't get divorced who have a shit manager. That's 75%. Who's going to jump out of that plane and take that 75% risk? Okay, no one who's sane. But then some other context like marriage, all of a sudden, that's a good risk. That's a good investment because you need to man up. No one's going to tell you to man up and jump out of a plane with a 75% chance of your parachute not working, okay? And that's basically because, you know, women aren't getting anything out of that deal. But of course, women don't make this charge against men who refuse to get married, because every man that doesn't get married, there's a woman who's missing out. Maybe more than one if you live in a polygamous country. Oh, and also, strong woman. You're afraid of the strong, independent woman. Well, if we're talking about someone who's fierce, I mean, yeah, I would be, I wouldn't say I'm afraid, but I would be inclined to not engage with someone who's very fierce, because I don't want to be nagged and bossed around all the time. Just like a woman wouldn't want a man who's very, very fierce, who's going to abuse her and hit her up, okay, and beat her. A woman should be maybe afraid or not engaging with men like that as well. Oh, and another reason why I might be afraid, quote unquote, of a strong independent woman is because she's quite likely to realize that she can be independent, quote unquote, and divorce rape me and take all my resources and be independent of my money without having any association with me through no fault divorce. And that's really the basic issue when it comes to things like this. That's why it's too risky, even for a confident man who's willing to take calculated risks.